Good afternoon, friends, and welcome to Munich, Germany, here at the 1972 Olympic Games venue for the first final of the day, 50-meter rifle, three positions woman. I'm Hilary Russell, and I have the pleasure of having Israel's rifle shooter, Anat Tazur, here with me today. Welcome, Anat. Thanks for joining us today.
Thanks. Welcome. It's so nice to be here.
It's nice to have you by my side. I'm sorry that you did not make it into the final. You had a really great day yesterday.
Yeah, you know. I did. But, you know, it's all good. There's a European next month.
That's so right. And you're getting ready to go there, and that will be wonderful. And hope and pray that you get a quota place.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I hope to. I hope so, too.
It's, we do have two quota places that are up for grabs today, and three out of the eight finalists can win them today. So they do have that stress, added stress of winning a quota place. And it's a really going to be a very, very tight final, as
yes,
there's only,
very,
what,
very
3 points from first to eighth place.
Well, I mean, it shows that the conditions today were pretty even throughout the shooting range. I mean, it doesn't really matter what firing point you get here in Munich.
Mm-hmm.
It's really equal here, and the terms here are great, especially today where, you know, the temperature was a little bit higher than the other days. I mean, I know that yesterday was so cold.
We it had was to really cold.
Like
yeah.
with hot hats and scarves and everything.
So let's take a look at the weather conditions today. It was mostly cloudy. It's 22 degrees Celsius. It's almost about 10 degrees warmer than yesterday. 64% humidity. The wind speed is 11 kilometers an hour, and the wind direction is southwest. Of course, none of this really affects us now because we're inside the finals hall.
Yeah, but today earlier you could totally feel, you know, feel the heat a little bit, and also it was a bit windy, so
mm-hmm.
you really had to, you know, take your time, not shoot, like, just wait for the right wing for the right conditions.
That's right. And in a minute, we're going to go over these details of the today's event, which I'm going to ask you to go over, Nat. That would be great. Here we go.
Yeah, well, today we're shooting an event of three positions women. The distance is 50 meters. The rifle is 5.6 millimeters. The maximum weight you can get is 6.5 kilograms. The ammunition we shoot it with is 5.6 millimeters long rifle. The bullseye is about 10.4 millimeters.
Mm-hmm.
And the number of shots in this final is 10, of course, and the time per shot is 75 seconds.
Here we have the ISSF VIPs that are here today, including the president himself, Mr. Olegario Vasquez Rania, who has come in to almost every World Cup, I believe almost maybe all of them this year.
I think so, yeah.
He's done a lot of traveling today. We have the vice president as well, Mr. Gary Anderson. We have the secretary general, Mr. Franz Schreiber, and Mr. Monterosso as well.
Here we are.
Here we are. We're going to have a chance to meet our finalists in just a couple minutes.
Shooters, please take your place to the public. World Cup Munich 2011. Welcome to the first final.
We have in eighth place, coming with 584 points, representing Slovakia, Daniela Peshkov.
Peshkova, yeah.
Peshkova. She's 27 years old. She won the silver medal in Bangkok in 2007 during the World Cup, and she also placed seventh in Milan in 2006 during the World Cup.
World champion in junior class in Lahti 2002 in Prone, and the seventh place at the World Championships in Lahti 2002 in 3x20. She's representing Slovakia, Daniela Peshkova.
Then in seventh place today, coming with 584 points, representing Germany, Barbara Lechner. She is currently ranked number 2 in the world. She won the gold medal and is the current world champion as of last year here in Munich. She also won the bronze medal during the World Cup final here in Munich in 2005. She won the gold medal during the World Cup in 2005 here in Munich. Obviously, Munich seems to be her place
yeah.
of glory.
She actually lives in Munich. Yeah.
So there you go. Then we have in sixth place, coming with 585 points, representing Great Britain, Michelle Smith. She's 28 years old. She plays 17th here in Munich during the World Championships. And she has never entered into a final round of a
yeah,
World
it's
Cup.
It's her first final, I bet she's really excited.
She must be very excited, but she's also one of the women that are eligible for a quota place.
Yeah, so that adds the pressure up. We'll see how she handles it.
Then in fifth place, coming with 585 points, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Wan Xiangyan. She's 24 years old. She won the silver in Shanghai in 2009 during the World Cup. And she's a three-time bronze medalist during the World Cup, once here in Milan in 2009, in Beijing in 2009, and in Sydney in 2007. And in fourth place, coming with 585 points, representing the Ukraine, we have Nathalia Kalnysh. She is 36 years old. She won the silver medal during the World Championships in Latvia in 2002. She also won the silver medal during the World Cup final here in Munich in 2002. And she's a four-time World Cup silver medalist and a one-time World Cup bronze medalist.
Yeah, well-experienced shooter.
Then in third place, coming in with 585 points, also representing Germany, we have Sonja Pfeilschifter. She's 40 years old. She won the gold medal during the World Championships in Barcelona in 1998. She won the silver here in 2010 during the World Championships. She's a two-time World Cup final gold medalist. She's a 12-time World Cup gold medalist. And I could go on and on with the medals, but we don't have enough time.
Yeah, she looks really focused.
She certainly does.
Ready.
Then coming in second place, representing the United States of America, we have Jamie Beyerle. She's 27 years old and currently ranked number one in the world. She was a junior during the World Championship, Junior World Championships in Lahti in 2002. She won the silver medal. She also won the gold during the World Cup final in here in Munich in 2010. And she also has a laundry list of medals. Then an interesting woman entering into first place with 586. She had Stine Nielsen from Denmark. She's 20 years old. She won the Junior World Championships in Munich last year. And she placed seventh during the World Cup in Fort Benning this year. Yeah. This is a new face for us.
And yeah, 20 years old. It's really good score for her.
It really, really is. I'll just go over the world record and final world record real quickly. They were both set by Sonja Pfeilschifter. Both of them were set here in 2006 during the World Cup. The world record is 594 and the final world record is 698 points. Now, I had an opportunity to do an interview today with Great Britain's team coach. He was talking about training for a 50-meter rifle, three positions women, and also his thoughts about his country hosting the 2012 games. So let's take a look at this interview. Donald, can you tell us what the training entails for a three-position woman?
Yeah, pretty intense schedule with the three-positions events because they have the three separate disciplines to master. And it's always the challenge striking a balance between the prone, the standing, and the kneeling. So they have to spend a lot of range time on all three. And every athlete's different in terms of the priority they'll put on that. The standing's crucial because it's the least stable position and it's the most important because of the final. But increasingly, again, the kneeling has come back to the fore now because there's so many good standing shooters out there. Kneeling is pretty complex, so we've kind of gone and seen a transition in the last few years with the kneeling coming back to more importance than maybe it was 4 or 5 years ago.
How do you feel about having the 2012 Olympic Games take place in Great Britain?
It's absolutely fantastic for us. A great opportunity. You know, really, really looking forward to it. We were in the middle of European Championships in Belgrade in 2005, and when the news came through that London had been awarded the games, and it's just been a bit of a roller coaster ever since. It's great. Really looking forward to it.
Well, as you can see, Donald McIntosh, Great Britain's coach, is very, very excited about the games that will be taking place in London next year.
And yeah, I think the shooting range is now, they finished building it, and it will be ready for March, for the pre-Olympics.
For the pre-Olympics. Once again, here we have the ISSF VIPs that are here. And it's just going to be a couple seconds before we get started on our first shot. Now, with a score so close like this, only 3 points between first and eighth, what do you think?
Every single shot counts. I mean, especially in standing in 50 meters, I mean, in a split second of you know, losing your concentration, the hips or the shoulders or whatever can move, and then you can, like, really, you know, suffer from it, like maybe get an eight or a far nine or... That's why you have to maintain your focus, your concentration through the whole shot, the whole time.
Especially if you have an unfortunate shot, then you really have to just get right back in it and not let that affect you. Is that right?
Exactly, exactly. It's very important to don't let, you know, the previous shot interfere your work. Mm-hmm. You know, because what was, you know.
What was, was.
What was, was, exactly. Yeah.
Easier said than done,
yeah,
also.
Exactly.
You know. We're going to get this started now. It's also a nice thing for Germany, the country of Germany, to have two of their shooters in the final today.
Attention. 3, 2, 1. stop.
Focusing in here on Barbara Lechner from Germany. And let's see how this goes now for Pfeilschifter and Lechner. 10.7 for Pfeilschifter.
Real quick to shoot.
Yes. And a nice way to start out the final.
Yeah, no doubt.
Nine point 2 for Lechner.
And she's not happy about it.
No. Pfeilschifter, who's always the last one to shoot.
Yeah.
This is when 75 seconds for the audience seems like about a half hour.
Yeah, but you know, with the shooters. Oh, well, there you go.
There you go, 10.9. That works out quite well. And finally, a nice look on her face. She doesn't look angry or.
Yeah. So far, so good for her.
So let's take a look at the standings. We have Nielsen is still in first place by 0.6 of a point over Pfeilschifter. Smith is in third place. And we have Wan and Beyerle that are in fourth and fifth place. And this is after Nielsen shot a 10.5, Beyerle a 9.7, Pfeilschifter 10.9.
As you can see from one shot, the medal picture changed. Mm-hmm. I mean, Pfeilschifter moved a place up, and we'll see how Beyerle, how it will affect her.
That's true. Kalnysh a 9.6, Wan a 9.9, Smith a 10.1, Lechner a 9.2, and Pfeilschifter a 10.7. Moving on to the second shot. This is where the 10.9s can just bounce you right up.
Yeah.
And anything.
It's always nice to have them.
Let's take a look now at Smith and Wan. Smith is also a very fast shooter, 9.8.
But I think by the way she's like doing with her head, I think she shot it too soon.
Mm-hmm.
She should have waited a little bit more.
Also 9.8 for Wan. A very unfortunate 8.6 for Nielsen, and she is shaking her head.
Yeah, you know, she's 20 years old. She's young a bit. She's like really excited. But it's a good experience for
it's
her.
It's true. After the second final shot. And that was a 10.1 for Pfeilschifter. Things are changing around, obviously. After Nielsen shot that 8.6, Pfeilschifter has now overtaken her by 0.9 of a point. Nielsen's holding on to second place by a mere 0.2 of a point over Smith. And Pfeilschifter is only 0.1 of a point behind Smith, and also Wan is 0.1 of a point. I mean, there's only a mere difference. This is after Nielsen shot at 8.6, Beyerle a 9.6, Pfeilschifter a 10.1, Kalnysh a 9.9, Wan a 9.8, Smith a 9.8, Lechner a 10.7, and Pfeilschifter a 10.1.
Yeah, and from what we can see after only two shots, the difference is still so close between each shooter.
Now, are you surprised to see so many on the second round here, so many shots that were in the nines?
You know, there's like the excitement of the first shot, and then maybe, you know, the second shot, you feel like you're doing the same thing, but maybe you lose your head for just 1 second, and then, you know, that's the exciting thing about the 50 meters. It's so important to stay focused the whole time.
Kalnysh and Pfeilschifter, 10.0 for Kalnysh. Waiting on Pfeilschifter now. Before you could hear the crowd kind of go, oh, and I'll be able to explain to you why in just a second. A 9.5 for Pfeilschifter. She's not happy with that shot. Also, it was an unfortunate 8.5 for Lechner from Germany. So the German people that are here to see their own
shot. Number
shoot.
Three was not a good shot
no,
for
it wasn't.
The German women.
But Nielsen has now overtaken Pfeilschifter after shooting a 10.6. She's holding on to first by 0.2 of a point. Smith is in third place still with 0.3 of a point over Kalnysh. She's 0.7 of a point now behind Smith. This is after Nielsen shot a 10.6. Barely a 9.5. Pfeilschifter also a 9.5. Kalnysh a 10.0. Wan a 9.6. Smith a 10.3. Lechner an unfortunate 8.5. And also for Pfeilschifter an unfortunate 8.5.
Yeah, that's exactly what I said before. I mean, you think maybe you made like a small, really small mistake, maybe with your hip, with your shoulders, but the difference with the rifle, with the barrel is so huge. That it can take the bullet up to an 8 or a far 9. That's
Stop. We're going to now focus in on Beyerle and Nielsen. Jamie Beyerle on our screen.
Yeah, she won the gold in her hometown.
Mm-hmm, she sure did. And that was just amazing. That was down to the very last shot, and I think no one saw that coming.
Yeah, but maybe she did.
It was really exciting to see that for Jamie. But we all know that she's got that in her. You know, she might be shooting the nines right now, but then all of a sudden she has something that comes and overtakes her, and bam, 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 gold medal. Nielsen and Beyerle both taking their time to shoot. A 10.2 for Nielsen. And this time, Beyerle is actually the last person to shoot a 9.4.
And she's not happy about that.
She looks a little bit shocked about that, in fact. Ms. Nielsen, 10.2. Nielsen is still holding on to first place. She's got that lead by 0.3 of a point over Pfeilschifter.
Yeah, barely.
Wan is in third place, and she's 0.9 of a point behind Pfeilschifter. Smith has now moved down into fourth place. She's only 0.1 of a point behind Wan, and Kalnysh is only 0.2 of a point behind Smith. This is after Nielsen shot a 10.2, Beyerle a 9.4, Pfeilschifter a 10.1, Kalnysh a 9.9, Wan a 10.4, Smith a 9.4, Lechner a 10.5, and Peskova a 9.6. We'll be moving on to the fifth shot in just a couple of minutes.
There's one, the Chinese, also fighting for a quarter place.
That's right. Nielsen won hers in Fort Benning.
Yeah, it was a very exciting time for her.
We do have these quarter places. The three women that are up for grabs to get them are Wan, Smith, and Pfeilschifter. Let's take a look now at Wan. Mm-hmm. 9.3. Nielsen a 9.4. And just waiting now on Pfeilschifter.
Again.
Of course. Ten 10.2 for Pfeilschifter. Stop. Take a look at the standings now. Pfeilschifter now has overtaken Nielsen. And she has the lead by half a point. Kalnysh is now in third place. She's 1.2 of a point behind Nielsen. And Wan is in fourth place, and she's 1/10 of a point behind Kalnysh. This is after Nielsen shot a 9.4, Beyerle a 10.0. Pfeilschifter a 10.2, Kalnysh a 9.7, Wan a 9.3, Smith an unfortunate 8.5, Lechner a 9.7, and Pfeilschifter a 10.2. Tell me what you think about these scores.
Well, at this point of the final, I mean, I know maybe some of the shooters, you know, keep track of their score, maybe looking, you know, on the other side to see what the other shooter is doing. But now it's like you have to, you know, just think about the next shot, the current shot, and nothing more.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's it.
Attention. Moving on to shot number 6.
1, start.
Kalnysh on our screen. Nine point six. Nielsen, wait for her shot. I know that she's eager to jump back up into first place, a 10.5.
And that's a good way to do it.
It certainly is, and she looks happy with that.
The patience that it takes to shoot the way Sonja does, it's really admirable. I mean, she waits until, you know, she sees the right picture, and, you know, she waits until the right time for her. And that's amazing. I mean, not for this shot, but, you know.
Right. 9.2, and you can tell that she's clearly frustrated by that shot. 10.5. And that's exactly what Nielsen needed to get back up into first place. And she's done that, and she's holding on to it by 8/10 of an advantage over Pfeilschifter. Kalnysh is now in third place. She's 1.3 tenths of a point behind Pfeilschifter, and Beyerle is now climbing up the scoreboard, as we know that she can do and always does. She is now 3 tenths of a point behind third place, and this is after Nielsen's shot, a 10.5. Beyerle a 10.2, Pfeilschifter a 9.2, Kalnysh a 9.6, Wan an 8.8. Smith, a 9.6, Lechner, a 9.5, and Peshkova, a 9.1. We have four more shots. What do you think is going to happen in these shots, Annette?
Anything can happen. I mean, even, you know, first place can suddenly go up, down, I don't know.
In a heartbeat?
It's so complicated. I really don't know.
It's nice to see the finals hall has filled up to see this event. Let's take a look now at Jamie Beyerle.
Currently ranked in fourth place.
Be interesting to know what's going through her mind right now.
Yeah.
Taking our time to get this right. A 9.3 for Beyerle.
And not a good final for her so far.
Waiting on now for a Pfeilschifter. Starting off with a 10.9.
Now 10.7.
We still have Nielsen holding on to first place, but now by a mere 2 tenths of a point. Pfeilschifter is in second place, and Kalnysh is now 2 points behind Pfeilschifter. Beyerle is now 1 point behind Kalnysh. This is after Nielsen shot a 10.1, Beyerle a 9.3, Pfeilschifter a 10.7. Kalnysh a 10.0, Wan a 9.4, Smith a 10.0, Lechner a 9.9, and Peshkova a 10.0.
Yeah, and currently Jamie and Michelle are tied up at fourth and fifth place. I mean, for Beyerle, maybe, you know, it's not so important to be fourth or fifth, but for Michelle it means, you know, a place in the 2012 London Olympics.
Exactly. So Smith really has got to focus in here and try to regain some points in order to get a quota place for the USA. I mean, for the USA, right.
For Great Britain.
For Great Britain.
The difference to Ms. Beyerle is 0.0.
Here we have Nielsen on our screen. She knows at this point that she only has a lead by 2 tenths of a point with the new procedures that we have.
Yeah.
Where the announcer is able to say what the scores are and exactly how many points are different between the shooters.
I think it's a good decision the ISSF made. I mean, it adds a lot of interest to the finals, to the viewers, even to the audience.
Exactly. Nielsen just waiting to get this right. 10.6, that's not a bad way to do
it
at all.
Right.
She did get it right, and you can tell that she's pleased with that. Beyerle, a 9.5. And now just waiting for Sonja Pfeilschifter to take her shot.
Takes a few breaths, you know, calming mm-hmm. herself down, making sure everything is in place. The hand, the left hand, the right hand, the cheek on the cheek piece. And when she shoots, it's a 10.
Mm-hmm. Let's take a look at the standings. We still have Nielsen. She's gaining some tenths of a point over Pfeilschifter.
Yeah, good for her. I mean,
really, really great.
20 years old and keeps up the...
You know, going up against yeah, such a veteran shooter such as Pfeilschifter, you know, there must be a little bit of nerves going on there,
yeah,
I would think.
For sure.
I'm sure. Nielsen's holding on to first place by 6 tenths of a point over Pfeilschifter. Kalnysh is now in third place. She's 3.5 tenths of a point out of second. Beyerle is only 2 tenths of a point behind Kalnysh and still tied up with Wan. So the fight for the bronze and the gold are on. The fight for the medals are on.
Yeah, as always.
I know. We have two more shots of this final to find out who's going to be on the three steps of the podium. It'll be interesting to see between Nielsen and Pfeilschifter, but also for this for the bronze medal between Kalnysh, Beyerle, and Wan.
And also the fight between the three shooters who are fighting for two quarter places.
Mm-hmm. That's true. Smith is only 2 tenths of a point behind Wan, so it's a fight for the quota place between the two of them. Three, moving on to three, the ninth shot. Here we've got Smith on our screen.
That will be fast.
9.1 for Smith.
Maybe too fast.
Yep. Lechner. 10.0. Waiting now for Nielsen. 10.3. Two more shots. We're waiting for Beyerle, who just shot, and now Pfeilschifter.
A
10.6. It's going to take a go down to the very last shot to find out who is going to be unbelievable. Nielsen still holding on to first place by, like you said, 3 tenths of a point over Pfeilschifter. Kalnysh is in a third place, and she doesn't have a chance for silver or gold. But the fight for the bronze is now on between Kalnysh, Lechner, who has moved up, Wan, and I would even say Peskova. More or less anybody, I think, has a chance now for the bronze medal.
So next competition,
I wish they could have measured the heartbeat of each shooter now.
Yeah.
Just to see how it is on the last shot.
Attention. 3, 2, 1.
Start. Nielsen's really got to shoot deep. Let's see if she can do this. Hold up to the pressure. Ooh. Uh-oh, 9.7 for Nielsen.
No, it's all up to Pfeilschifter. People are starting to whisper now.
Mm-hmm, they certainly are.
They sense maybe a gold is coming.
Mm-hmm. She certainly makes the audience wait to the very last second to find out who's going to be going home with the gold, doesn't she? 10.6 for Pfeilschifter. That's enough for the gold medal. And you can hear the crowd is very, very pleased and a smile on Sonja Pfeilschifter's face. down to the very last shot, and here she is, gold medalist Sonja Pfeilschifter. She's, you can tell she's excited as all get out. We have Nielsen, who has won the silver medal and Wan moved up and overtook third place. So Wan has also won a quota place as well as
Peshkova.
Here she is, our gold medalist, Sonja Pfeilschifter.
She looks really happy.
She does.
For her, winning in Germany means a lot.
It sure does. Here's our silver medalist today, Stine Nielsen from Denmark. She did a fabulous job today. Just a last shot that kind of fouled her up, but still going home with a silver medal.
Yeah, she'll
showing,
be happy.
Yeah,
she's happy.
She's a young girl. She's got a future ahead of her. And to put the pressure on a veteran shooter like Sonja Pfeilschifter, I have to take my hat off to her. And our silver, our bronze medalist, Wan from the People's Republic of China, also winning Olympic Games quota place for China. Really exciting final today, as they have been all week long. And Matt, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thanks for having me.
And
always happy to be here.
Just want to wish you the best of luck during the European Championships.
Thanks so much.
Go get them. Go get that quota place for Israel, okay?
Okay.
All right. Everybody stay tuned in, because we do have another final today, and that is going to be at 2 o'clock local time, and it's 10-meter air pistol men.